What is up, you guys? This is Mini Superheroes Today.
And today we'll be taking a look at the new Summer 2020 LEGO Marvel Spider-Man set 76151 Venomosaurus Ambush. This set has 640 pieces, is for ages 8 and up, has 4 minifigures, plus a skeleton, and retails for $79.99 in the United States. Now, this is one of the more expensive LEGO Marvel sets in a while, so the question is this really worth $80? And we're going to unpack that and answer all of it in today's video. So, the premise of the set is that this dinosaur got taken over by the Venom symbiote, Venom's got it going, and we've got 3 spider heroes here to save the day. And of course, we've got another useless Spider-Man vehicle, although I do think this one's pretty cool. I just, in general, really don't like Spider-Man vehicles because he's like the one superhero that doesn't need one. In any case, let's start taking a look at these figures. It only makes sense that we start with Spider-Man himself. This is the same Spider-Man we've gotten many, many times over the past couple years, but the printing on mine's eye is kind of messed up. Can you see that? Let me zoom in and see if you can see how the printing on the eye there is just a little bit off. Anyways, it's not a huge deal. It's just something I noticed and it was probably worth pointing out. We've also got a new Iron Spider here. Now, of course, we got the MCU Iron Spider at one point, and then we did get a comic one a few years ago, but we've got another comic one here, and the detailed printing is really nice on this one. It's just not quite the classic Iron Spider look. It's definitely a more updated version, but it's a really great-looking figure nonetheless. The big draw for this set should be to nobody's surprise, which is Spider-Ham, the Spider-Man pig, Peter Porker. It's a really great figure. I love the new printing on the back and the front of the torso, and of course this head mold, which debuts in this set, is really fantastic. He's got a little hot dog here. The only thing I think could have been better is if he had mid-sized legs that would have like had posability to them like the Harry Potter figures do, but even then, it's still a fantastic figure. Then we do have this Venom here, and it's the same Venom minifigure we've gotten before, but he's got this back brace that has all these black Venom web accessory pieces on it, which is really, really cool. He's got this big kind of like hammer scythe thing. Overall, it's a really great figure. It's just a bummer that it's the same Venom we've gotten as before, even though these new accessories are nice additions. So that's pretty cool, and that's it for the figures. Now we do have these Venom web handcuffs here, which on the packaging and in the instructions, really, the idea is to put these on Iron Spider, and then he could be drug along like that with these handcuffs. So kind of a neat idea in and of itself. Starting with the smallest part of this build, we have this little egg contraption thing here, which is really the premise of the set, right? We've got this skeleton here, which isn't anything too unique for a LEGO skeleton, just what we always get, but looks like they were experimenting on this egg and the symbiote broke out of it or got into it, and then that's how the dinosaur got taken over. So that's kind of neat. And I pulled off this skeleton from the set here because we'll come to him in just a moment. But we do have this spider vehicle here. It's kind of like a spider monster truck. It's a really big build. You can see these huge, massive tires on it. A lot of stickers, though, guys. Over all 4 wheels, we've got a sticker up front here and 2 stickers on the front for these headlights. But the build in and of itself at the end looks really good. There's a posable cannon gun on the back here, and the idea is for Spider-Ham to be able to click on there with the 2 little studs that show up. And then Spider-Man is supposed to drive, as you can see right there. So that's pretty cool. But all in all, it does have this new launcher piece here, which when you click this red button in the back, it would launch this missile out. And there's a lot of force behind that spring. So that's a really cool vehicle. And then there is a play feature in that the wheels kind of have these shocks on them that can push down. So if we drive it here, you can see that it can push down and then it can pop up too. So pretty cool. See it push down and pop up. It only takes a little bit of force to get it to go one way or the other, but the shock system is very cool with those rubber bands that run along the bottom. So it's a really nice vehicle. Now let's clear the playing field here to take a look at the Venomosaurus dinosaur, because this thing is really fantastic. So you can see how massive it is. In fact, I'm gonna put Venom on the back here, where he has a little place right here with these 2 studs that you're able to sit him on the back to control the dinosaur. But you can see that this thing is absolutely huge. So we'll start off with the head, which just popped off right in my hand, as you can see. So the head goes on this neck joint here, so the neck joint can move up and down like that.
Then the head itself is on this ball pivot joint, which can kind of go like 360 in kind of like a roundabout way, if you will. But the mouth opens a little wider and the tongue can move too, so that's pretty cool. Definitely one of those signature Venom things. I love the way that they built the teeth in the mouth too. It's got a really great look. I love the way that the eyes are constructed. Being a dinosaur, a T-Rex itself, it does have these small little hands down here with these little grabby fingers for the tiny dinosaur hands. Very cool look. And I like that all these 2x2 kind of sloped pieces actually are printed, but a lot of the ones like on the top of the head here and on the sides are all stickers. So it's kind of interesting how some were stickers and some weren't. But something kind of weird is you can open the back of the abdomen here and you can actually fit the skeleton inside of the back there. So I just thought that was kind of weird. I don't know why that would make sense, but it was a lot of wasted space on the figure if they didn't do anything with it. It's just kind of weird if you ask me. As far as the legs both have the same amount of poseability. You can move them at the hips right here, and then they don't really move at the knees, but they do move at the ankles. So you can get kind of like a power stance going. You can position him more upward like that. And then the tail moves right here at the base. There's a point of articulation there, and then again at the end. So it's a really solid build for this dinosaur. And when I say solid, I mean like solid man, but also it's a very solid build in and of itself. It's not too terribly flimsy. It's not going to fall apart on you. There's a lot of great play features that are rounded into it. So it's a really great build. I really like it. And that's pretty much the whole set. So the question comes down to, is this worth $80? And guys, I'm just not sure it is. Now, if you are new to LEGO Marvel, you don't have a lot of sets, you don't have Spider-Man yet, you don't have Iron Spider, you don't have Venom, this is a great way to get a lot of key figures in the Spider-Man line, and of course the new Spider-Ham is great, but by and large, I'm just not sure if this is worth $80. I mean, $80 is a lot of money, guys. You could get a lot of $20 sets for that, or, you know, 20 and a 30, and add all that up, so I just don't know if it's worth the price tag on this one. Now, LEGO sets often will go on sale or on clearance, so my recommendation would be, if you can absolutely wait for this, I would wait until you could get it on sale or on clearance or something, because, you know, all LEGO sets go on sale eventually, and this may be one of those ones that it's worth waiting for. But drop a comment below, let me know what you think. I'm always curious. If you are interested in ordering this, I'll drop an affiliate link in the description below. You can help support my channel. Won't cost you a dime to do. Dime extra, that is. You'll still have to pay for the set. But in any case, be sure to hit like and subscribe for more videos. Let me know what you want to see next. Thanks for checking out this review, and I'll see you guys on the next video. If you liked what you saw and you liked what you heard, feel free to click that subscribe button for more LEGO content coming in the near future. So, thanks for tuning in to today's video, and until next time, build on.